Hello. Today we're going to be doing a tutorial in Affinity Publisher version 2, and we're going to look at creating pins in Affinity Publisher. So in this first tutorial, we're going to look at basic setup and basic Affinity features like using text, using shapes, and using images. If you know all of this already, you probably do not need this lesson. But stick around for the subsequent videos because we're going to have some little tricks to accelerate creating in Publisher, some little hacks that I want to share with you. So this first tutorial in this series is going to be just basic making a Pinterest image. All right, let's get started. So I'm in Affinity Publisher version 2. The first thing I want to do is set up a new document. So I'm going to click on File and New. Now, there are some presets in here, and if we look at the web section, there are some social media images. Right now, as I film this, 1,000 pixels by 1,500 pixels is the recommended Pinterest size. I don't have those options here in my presets, so I'm going to create one. So over here, I want to click on the layout, and then in the page width, I've already done this, so it's defaulting to my last numbers that I used, but we're going to put 1,000 pixels, 1,500 pixels. DPI, I'm going to have that at 144. So Pinterest pins are never going to be printed out. They are always going to be on the screen. So really 72 is perfectly adequate for our DPI, but in case someone's got like a more high quality device, like a Retina or whatever, I'm going to do 144 so that my images look good. For pages, just make sure facing pages is unchecked. Leave the color alone. We don't need any margins. We don't need any bleed because we're not printing it. Now, if I want to save this as a template, I can go to this left-hand side here, and in the very bottom left corner, there's a little icon with a plus symbol that says Add New Preset. So let's add a preset. We'll call it Pinterest Pin. For the category, I'm going to put this with the web where all my other social media templates are. And for the icon, it looks like all my web ones have this kind of laptop image. So I'm going to pick that as my icon and say OK. And there it added my template. So if I create future Pinterest documents, I can just go to this template. Now let's hit the button for create, and here we have our document. All right, so now if we look at our pages window, I'm just going to drag that out so we can see it. And I'm actually going to just get rid of all of these. There's that, so that we just have pages. All right, so I have a section here for master pages and for pages. So master pages, you can kind of think of it as a template. And everything that we put on this master page will appear on every page that we apply that template to in our actual document. So on the master, I'm going to double click on it. I'm going to make sure that it is outlined. That shows that it's selected. What I want to do is I just want to add some stuff that I want to appear on every single pin. So over here on the left, I'm going to choose the rectangle tool. And I'm going to click on that, and then I can, with my mouse, draw out a little rectangle here across the bottom. And I'm just going to leave it gray for the moment. And then back to the artistic text tool here. So I'm going to click on this A here, and I'm just going to hold my mouse and drag out a little bit. And this is where I will put my site.com. Here is the name of my site. And now, because I used artistic text, I can just grab one of the corner dots or handles and just rescale it. I'm going to switch back to Move Tool. And I have snapping or magnetics on up here, this little magnet symbol. And that way, when I move this box, it's going to give me a line that shows me I'm perfectly centered. And then I can drop that down until I'm perfectly centered within my little gray box. All right, so now my template is set up, and I'm going to go to Pages, and you can see that my master is applied here. You can right-click on this page and we could clear masters. And now you see we have a blank page. And then I can apply master. And that way I can have different pin templates set up here if I wanted to. But let's just click on master A again. And I want to apply it to all pages and we'll say okay. So now it'll appear on all my pages. Let's go ahead and place an image. Now in document setup, under document, it defaults to prefer embedded. I want to switch this to prefer linked. This is not going to be an issue in this particular video, but I want to show you some other things that you can do later in separate videos. This will be important, so prefer linked. Okay. Now let's go ahead and place an image. So file place, and I'm just going to find my pin images. I have a image labeled pin 1. I'll just say okay. And then click anywhere on our screen to place this. And I just got this image out of Pixabay. I'm going to command or control if you're on a PC with the hyphen, and that will help me to zoom out with some keyboard shortcuts. And then we can place this. And I want this, I'm going to drag it down and to the left so that it is underneath my master. And that way, I can see the little logo here that I created. Now, I want to sample this color here. I want to go to this color picker and I want to sample this color. And then up here in my master, I want to click on this rectangle and it's in my swatches kind of being remembered here. Okay. So now we have, let's click back on our page here. Now we have our pin set up. We've got a color that matches here in this bar and we've got our logo applied. So let's look at placing some text. Now I want to pop over to Pinterest and I just have travel, but if you look at food, this is going to be even more the case. Pinterest has changed in the last couple of years. Used to buy all these sorts of pin templates, like something like this, like this, like this. But see if you notice anything as you scroll. What I'm noticing is there are a lot of pins here that are just images. All right. And it makes sense because as you're scrolling, you know, I've put travel in here. It's like, oh, where's that? I don't know unless I click on it and look at the title. So it's clickbaity in and of itself to say, oh, where's that? 10 best things to buy in Iceland. So the idea of putting a whole lot of text on the image is actually so 2019, but you may want to know how to do that anyway. So let's look at how we can. So I'm going to grab the artistic text tool again. I'm going to draw out a really big one and we'll say 9. And then I'm going to draw out another one, click away to deselect that first one, and then draw out another one. And we'll say breakfast ideas. Okay, so now I'm going to go back to the move tool so I can select this 9. We'll make it even bigger. And in our swatches over here, let's just make that white. And then breakfast ideas, I'm going to pick that same blue in the swatches from my recents. Now, let's make this pop a little bit more. So I'm going to, with my swatches here, click on this little donut one, which currently has the red line through it, which means that I have no stroke on this. And let's just put a black stroke on it. In the stroke window, you can kind of mess with the size. Now, I don't want it to look outlined. I want it to have just enough and probably something like 0.5 or 0.6 is probably where I want to be. I want it just enough that it becomes just a little bit apparent. So if we turn it off versus putting it back on, it just gives it, it's just one way that you can make your number pop out a little bit. But like I said, I want that stroke to be so faint that you barely see it. Now, we can see it on my big image, but I kind of consider this pages window to be a little bit of a preview of what something might look like as we're scrolling. And so to me, that 9 pops a little bit more here without looking like it's outlined. All right, so let's go to breakfast ideas. And I want to find my quick effects, which should be over here on the right-hand side. I'm going to drag it out so we can see it. If you don't see any of these windows, go to the window menu and make sure that they have a check mark next to it. So I'm going to put an outer shadow on it, which is essentially putting a drop shadow on it. It gives me some basic options here, but if I click on this little gear, I'm going to get a few more options. So you want to make sure the check mark is on and that you have that thing highlighted. So outer shadow is what has the blue on it. And let's just put up the radius a little bit, put up the offset, which is how far away the shadow is. And I don't want like a huge drop shadow. I just want to make this pop a bit. And then we can go up with the intensity a little bit as well. And just enough, kind of make this pop a little bit. Okay, I think that's good enough. All right, so there's our first pin done. Let's go to pages and we will just add another page. So the little plus symbol, and we will add a page. Here's my second page. So for this one, I'm going to go file, place. We'll find our second pin image. Let's get all this stuff out of the way. We'll open that. We got some grapes here. Same thing. I'm going to, in my layers, drag it underneath this master layer so that it is under everything. Now, for this one, I just want to show you one more thing, and that will be to just draw out a square here. Let's make that white. And a common thing in these sorts of backgrounds on Pinterest pins is to have it be semi-transparent. So I'm going to have this rectangle layer selected in my layers panel, and up here where it says opacity, we'll just turn this down a little bit. And then also in my swatches, I'm going to click the fill and just make sure it's white. And I think we need just a little bit more opaque, so we'll turn it up again a little bit, about 92%. So you can see the image, but now lines to, we'll call it that. Center it, and definitely can see the outline here. So in my swatches, or in color, you can do it in either of these windows. I'm just going to turn that stroke off. And then let's go to the color picker tool again, and maybe we'll sample this. Oops. Make sure that we're on the fill, the solid colored circle here. Color picker tool, apply to selection is on, and then let's pick something from one of these grapes. There. Let's do that. And then, oh, one more thing. Let's go back to our text tool, highlight all of this, and let's choose a nicer font. So just something a little bit more scripty, a little more handwritten, and we can maybe shrink this up a little bit and call it good. Okay, so now we have our two pins. I want to show you one more thing before we export this, and now you see how these are hanging off the edge. You can see the outline of your pin document, but the pictures are bigger than the document. So if that bothers you as you are designing, you'll notice when you hover on this little icon in the layers, it's an image layer right now. If I have this image selected and I right click and I scroll down, I can find an option that's rasterize and trim. If I click on that, you'll notice my icon has now changed to a checkerboard, and it says it's a pixel layer, and it is now trimmed to the size of my document. So if it bothers you to have the image hanging over the edges of your document, if it throws you, you can do that. Now, like I said, in a future video, I'm going to show you a way to change out the image if you are coming to create a new set of images from the same file. So I don't want to leave it like this. I'm going to Control Z or Command Z to undo that so that it turns back to an image layer again. So, but I just wanted you to be aware of that. Now let's export these. So I'm going to go to File, Export, and up here, I want to select whatever I want. I'm going to go JPEG. And we already set this at 144 DPI, so I'm not going to bother about the quality, and I'm not going to change anything else. We're just going to export. I will export it in one demo and save. And let me just go back and just show you one more thing. Export. I want to also export all pages. If you wanted to do just one, you could do the current page, but I'm doing all. So now if I go into my Finder, my downloads, here's my one pin. Here's my other pin. All right. So let's save this. File. Save. And then I'm going to do pin video demo. I'm just going to save it to my downloads, and we're going to save it, and we're going to call this tutorial good for now, and I will see you in the next video where we're going to talk about swapping out images.